Well, hello there, and welcome to Storytime Online. My name is LaKisha Kinsey-Sallis, and it is with great excitement that I bring you today's reading. Today's book is called Of Thee I Sing. It's a book written by our 44th National President, Barack Obama, and it's letters to his daughters about some of the fantastic people in our history that have made our America what it is today. This reading is brought to you with permission from Scholastic Incorporated. I hope you enjoy it. I hope you think. I hope you dream. I hope you ask questions and answer questions today. And most importantly, I hope you enjoy. Before we get started, I just wanted to show you or share with you a few things. On the back of this book, and just look at this beautiful, beautiful cover. It says, "Have I told you that America is made up of people of every kind?" What do you think that question means? Is he referring to places where people have come from? Is he referring to the race and skin tone of people? Is he talking about the life journeys that we all go through, or just the wonderful talents and gifts that we have? I don't know, but let's read the story and see where it goes. So just to give you some more context to the book, in the beginning it says that in this beautiful letter to his daughters, President Barack Obama has written a moving tribute to 13 groundbreaking Americans and the ideals that have shaped our nation. Do you have any clue who those 13 might be? Any hands raised out there? Well, let's see. From the artistry of Georgia O'Keeffe to the courage of Jackie Robinson, is that a name you know? From the strength of Helen Keller, how about that one? To the patriotism of George Washington, you gotta know that one, right? President Barack Obama sees the traits of these heroes within his own children and within all of Americans' children like you. The book starts, "Have I told you lately how wonderful you are? How the sound of your feet running from afar brings dancing rhythms to my day. How you laugh and sunshine spills in the room." And if I had to guess, since this is a tribute to his daughter, this is an illustration of his two daughters, Sasha and Malia, who now have grown a lot now, and maybe the family dog there. "Have I told you that you are creative?" A woman named Georgia O'Keeffe moved to the desert and painted petals, bone, bark. She helped see big beauty in what is small, the hardness of stone and the softness of a feather. What do you think she's painting here? Any guess? Well, as the book suggests, she is one of our artists as a part of our history. And if she's a name that you haven't heard, maybe this summer you'll take the opportunity to learn more about her. "Have I told you you are smart? That you braid great ideas with imagination?" A man named, before I read it, anybody know who it is? Albert Einstein, is that who you guessed? Great job. Albert Einstein turned pictures in his mind into giant advances in science, changing the world with energy and light. Anybody know one of the inventions that Albert Einstein is known for? What'd you guess? What if we never had Albert Einstein? Where would the world be? This book highlights the important people that are part of making our world just as great as it is. "Have I told you that you are brave?" Now, before I read the name, anybody know who that figure is? Jackie Robinson. Jackie Robinson played baseball and showed us all how to turn fear to respect and respect to love. He swung his bat with grace and strength of a lion and gave brave dreams to other dreamers. Are you a dreamer? Have you thought about what you want to do with your life? Are you the next Jackie Robinson out there? This great picture illustrates just what a great figure in our history Jackie Robinson is. If you see here in this picture, there's a boy with a bat. A boy who just had a dream, and that boy went on to be the Jackie Robinson. That could be you one day. Have I told you that you are a healer? Sitting Bull was a medicine man who healed broken hearts and broken promises. It is fine that we are different, he said. I'm going to read that again. It is fine that we are different. For peace, it is not necessary for eagles to be crows. Though he was put in prison, his spirit soared free on the plains and his wisdom touched the generations. Have I told you that you have your own song? Any singers out there? A woman named Billie Holiday, is that a name you've heard before? Wore a gardenia in her hair and sang beautiful blues to the world. Her voice, full of sadness and joy, made people feel deeply and their melodies to the chorus. Again, much like that picture we saw, the little boy, here if you can see it, there's a girl there, a little girl, who just like Jackie Robinson had a dream and went on to sing beautiful, beautiful notes, and she would be Billie Holiday. Have I told you you are strong? A woman named Helen Keller fought her way through long, silent darkness. Though she could not see or hear, she taught us to look at and to listen at each other. Never waiting for life to get easier, she gave others courage to face their challenges. What challenges are you facing? What Helen Keller showed us is no matter what challenges you are facing, you can do anything you put your mind to it. Could you imagine living in a space where even though you had no sight or you had no ability here, you could still move mountains and do wonderful things? Well, guess what? This book shows us that you too, no matter what your challenges or differences might be, can be the next Helen Keller. Have I told you how important it is to honor others' sacrifices? A woman named Maya Lin designed the Vietnam Veterans Memorial to remember those who gave their lives in the war, and the Civil Rights Memorial to thank many who fought for equality. Public spaces should be filled with art, she thought, so that we could walk amidst it, recalling the past and inspired to fix the future. Have you thought about what equality means, or do you know what equality means? Talk to me about it. What do you think Maya Lin was thinking about when she wanted something that was a reflection of equality and honoring those who come before us? Ponder on this statement that public spaces should be filled with art so that we can walk amidst it, recalling the past, inspired to fix the future. What are you doing to fix the future? Have you thought about what your future looks like and what you want to do? Have I told you you are kind? A woman named Jane Addams fed the poor and helped them find jobs. She opened doors and gave people hope. She taught adults and invited children to play and let their spirits grow wide. A servant she was. What are you doing to help the next person? Have I told you that you don't give up? I think this picture is very powerful. I'm gonna zoom in up there for you so you can see it. Anybody know who that person is? Did you guess Martin Luther King? Well, you're right. When violence erupted in our nation, a man named Martin Luther King Jr. taught us unyielding compassion. He gave us a dream that all races and creeds, would walk hand in hand. He marched and he prayed, and one at a time opened hearts and saw the birth of his dream in us. Do you know what they're referring to when they talk about the dream in us? Anybody familiar with Martin Luther King's I Have a Dream speech? What dream did he have? What dreams do you have? Again, this book demonstrates that you can dream as much as you want to dream, and you can be whatever you put your mind to it. Ah, have I told you you are an explorer? A man named Neil Armstrong was the first to walk on the moon. He watched the world from way up high, and he watched his lunar landing leaps, which made us brave enough to take our own big, bold strides. Neil Armstrong. Have I told you that you are inspiring? A man named Cesar Chavez showed farm workers their own power when they felt they had none. The people were poor, but worked hard and loved the land. Cesar picketed, prayed, and talked. The people listened to their hearts and marched their rights. Si se puede, Cesar said, which means, yes, you can. Always remember that, yes. You can. Have I told you that you are part of a family? A man named Abraham Lincoln knew that all of America should work together. He kept our nation one and promised freedom to enslaved sisters and brothers. This man of the people, simple and plain, asked more of his country than we behave as kin. Have I told you to be proud that you are an American? Our first president, anybody know who it is before I reveal the name? Did you guess George Washington? Way to go. Our first president, George Washington, believed in liberty and justice for all. His barefoot soldiers crossed wintry rivers, forgiving ever on. He helped make an idea into a new country, strong and true. A country of principle, a country of citizens. Before I read this page, I just want to show you the beauty in this. Remember at the beginning when I told you the book asks the question, have I told you that America is made up of people of every kind? Look at all these people of every kind reflected here. Do you see yourself in this image? I hope you do. These faces of young people reflect the culture and the fabric of our wonderful country that make us so unique and special. People of all races, religions, and beliefs. People from the coastlines and the mountains. People who have bright lights shine by sharing their unique gifts and giving us the courage to lift one another up, to keep up the fight, to work and build upon all that is good in our nation. So when I asked you earlier about what the message meant when it said people of all kind, I asked you, what do you think they were talking about? And I think here in this page, it gives us a clue. People of all races, religions, belief, from all different coastlines and mountains, meaning from all geographic areas with unique gifts and talents. So think about yourself. Think about your friends. Think about your family members and just how unique each one of you are in your own right, based on where you come from, based on what you've experienced, and the unique talent and skills that you have, and what you're doing with those things, or will do in the future, to help work and build upon our nation. Have I told you that they are all part of you? Have I told you that you are one of them? And that you are the future. And have I told you that I love you? The end. And there at the end is a picture of our President Barack Obama walking hand in hand with his daughters. So what'd you think about that book? Did you enjoy it? Did you learn about somebody new? I can tell you what my favorite part of the book, and I hope it was your favorite part too, is when the question was asked, have I told you that America is made up of people of every kind? And just again, this beautiful illustration of the uniqueness of the people that make up our nation. People of different sizes, colors, shapes, talents, gifts, origin, you name it. We have a wonderful and diverse culture that makes up our wonderful country. And I'm so glad that the book illustrator did such a great job of bringing that point to life. So just to go over some of the names that we talked about today, and I encourage you, if these were new names, to do more research so you know about these people. So you learned about Georgia O'Keeffe, who was one of America's best known artists. You learned about Albert Einstein. Hopefully he's not a new name, but he was known for his theory on relativity and just all the wonderful advances he made in science. Jackie Robinson, he excelled in athletics early and became the first African-American to play Major League Baseball since the sport had previously been segregated. Sitting Bull was a leader who spoke out and led his people against many policies in the United States. Billie Holiday, she became one of the defining singers of American popular music and jazz. Her famous performances include What a Little Moonlight Can Do, God Bless the Child, Summertime, and Stormy Weather. Helen Keller, you learned that she was deaf and blind and that she became world-renowned as an author and activist. Maya Lin was an artist and an architect who was best known for her design of the Vietnam Veterans Memorial in Washington, D.C. Jane Addams was responsible for eradicating poverty and promoting peace. She was the second woman to receive the Nobel Peace Prize. Is that an award you've heard of before? If not, put that on your list of things to look at and research this summer on your break. Dr. Martin Luther King was another name we revisited today. He is well known for his inspiring leadership of the nonviolent movement for social change, including the Montgomery bus boycott and the March on Washington in 1963. He also received a Nobel Peace Prize. Neil Armstrong was another name you heard. He was the first to walk on the moon in 1969 as a part of the Apollo 11 mission. You may have heard this famous quote, and it pertains to him, that goes, quote, "There's one small step for a man and one giant leap for mankind." He also received a Presidential Medal of Freedom that same year. Cesar Chavez was a major leader also for his people with respect to nonviolent movement for the rights and dignity of farm workers. He co-founded the National Farmers Workers Association, which later became the United Farm Workers and won many crucial labor reforms. We heard about presidents Abraham Lincoln, who was the 16th president, and George Washington, who was the first president of the newly formed United States in 1732. And then one person that we saw in our book, but we didn't hear about, and I just want to end with, is Barack Obama. He is our 44th president of the United States. He was born in Hawaii to a mother from Kansas and a father from Kenya. He himself is now the father of two daughters, Malia and Sasha. It was spending time with them that inspired him to write this book that we read today, Of Thee I Sing. After Barack Obama became president, he and his wife and their daughters moved to the White House in Washington, D.C., where they currently live at the time the book was written with their dog, Bo. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this book as much as I did. I've enjoyed my time with you. I will probably read this book again, and I encourage you to find a copy and read it too. Thank you for joining me.